Welcome back to section three of S&G and the Green Story. In closing here, we wanted to get into S&G's view of the green products and kind of how we want to promote them as a company. So, Fernando, you've done such a great job so far. You've been talking 20 minutes about the green story. Let's wrap it up and kind of give the folks what we're looking at here.
Why stop now? Okay. Well, basically, it's just the idea that I wanted to kind of finish with is that, you know, there is a green story, but then there's also green marketing out there, and I don't want to confuse the two. We haven't spent a ton of time doing the green marketing, and that the reason why I say that is we're not in it to do a cash grab and try and maximize our opportunity and say, oh, there's green products, we're going to plaster everything with we sell green and try and make as much money off it as possible. We're trying to stick to the facts. Mm-hmm. I think there's probably companies out there, I know there are some in this area, and I'm sure there's some in the Bay Area, where they're trying to say they're solely green, and I don't know how responsible they're being with it, but what I do know is I feel like S&G is being very responsible with it. Mm-hmm. As you noticed over the last two segments that we spent, we're going over some basic facts that we can use to sell green without overselling it to the customer, without using any sort of fear-mongering or you better buy this because if you don't, you're not being green. That's not what it's about. It's still all about what we've always been. We're selling service. Mm-hmm. We're selling great customer service, and we're trying to sell the customer what they want. And in that process, if we can educate them on the green story, or if they come in and ask about it, and we can direct them in a way that makes them feel good that they're making eco-friendly choices and green decisions, then that's what it's all about to me. Mm-hmm. Not necessarily pushing them into a product or scaring them away from other products, mm-hmm. but if they want to be green, let's help them do that.
Okay. Now, if I were to ask you, probably the most recognized green product in the flooring industry seems to be bamboo. Bamboo always comes up when people talk about green flooring because, as you mentioned earlier, it is a fast-growth bush, not even a tree. But if you look at a bamboo bush or tree and you look at how it turns into actual flooring, it's obvious that that product has been glued together, heated, stained,
finished.
In a lot of cases, finished with a melamine or aluminum oxide, urethane type of finish, which all is going to have some type of VOC.
Exactly, and that's kind of the point. Ultimately, we can be as green as possible and try and be conscientious about showing green, but I mean, unless S&G's answer is we're going to rip out your floor and your concrete and let you walk on dirt, you can only be so green. So what we try and do is give them as green of a product as possible. But ultimately, we have to understand there's two sides to every story.
Right.
There's two sides of the coin. Yeah, bamboo, we're not doing deforestation. We're not, you know, being irresponsible. But yeah, we're going to use, there's got to be chemicals and glues used. So you can only be so green.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to be as green as possible if that's what the customer's looking for. But we don't want to oversell it. We don't want to mislead the customer. We want to be responsible and, as Bill Kavanaugh likes to say, we like to be that shining light in our industry and be as honest and forthright with the customer while giving them what they want.
Okay. Now, as an S&G policy or general opinion, if someone were to come into the store and ask and say, you know, I have a lot of allergies, I'm extremely sensitive to any type of product, what would be the advice that you'd want to give to the salespeople?
Well, simple. I've actually helped a couple customers like that, and a lot of what you can show them is give them some preventative maintenance. Things you can explain to them is the fact that if it was a really extreme case, what I did for one customer, she bought a small piece of carpet, is we unrolled it for her the night before. Can we do that for every customer? Probably not, but on the occasion where a customer, that's important to them, we unroll it, we let it sit out overnight so it can kind of air out. We also let them know, you know, we can talk to the installer about making sure they get as many windows and doors open as possible during the installation, and let the customer know, even after the installation, if they can keep some doors open, keep some air running through the mm-hmm. through the house, that's going to make a huge difference for them.
Okay.
And that's not doing anything outrageous. That's just some simple preventative steps that can maybe minimize some of the effects the new floors might have on them.
Okay. I also want to point out that it also goes back to the consumer's responsibility, if you will.
Absolutely.
We're more than willing to let them take home samples. We tell them what the fiber content is or what the wood is. And they, you know, it comes down to them if they're ultra sensitive. boy, they're going to have to make that decision on their own. We're not doctors. We're not respiratory therapists or anything like that. Or mm-hmm. we don't even get close to knowing anything about that. So, you know, the best we could do is let them take samples home, give them whatever information we can, and have them make their own informed decision.
Absolutely.
So, okay.
They just want to know that we're willing to do a little extra for them. That's why people shop with S&G in the first place. They know, you know, if they brought that question up to a big box store, they'd probably get shrugged shoulders, but at least we're going to try and do something to help and at least give them that little bit of extra education that might minimize this process's effect on them, whether it's their health or the impact we have on their house when we do furniture moving or anything else we do. It's just another part of our service.
Okay, very good, very good. Fernando, thank you so much for taking the time to research it. I hope everybody gets a chance to watch the video. I know it's a long one, but a lot of good information in there and things that you're going to run up against as customers come in and start asking. So with that, thank you very much. Take care.